Cicely. Ai. Uma moça do historial de si. Ah, Jesus. Wow, Cicely, okay, there was a time I have somebody that was disturbing me. And I was like, I met this person in school when we resumed. I met this person and I was like, oh God, what is wrong? And I was like, ha, me, I'm not on my own. I don't even have anything like that in my mind. And this person kept on disturbing me, disturbing me, disturbing me. I was like, okay, come to my hostel. Me, I don't go out. That's one thing. If you want to take me out, okay, maybe I will change now. I'll start going out. Maybe I will change. I'll start going out. But not out, though. I'm Kenny, filming all the way from Ogun State here in Nigeria. I film about lifestyle challenges, faith, and purpose. So today I'm going to be talking about religion versus relationship. You know, we have some of our sisters or our brothers in the Lord. Yes. Well, okay. I actually was with my father in the Lord one day. Okay, let me say. As the Lord will ordain that day, as the Lord will ordain my step or my walk, or how will I even say it's my journey that day, I shall have met him. Shall fortunately for me, I met him. He was just busy, and then it was like, mommy came across my status on WhatsApp. Mommy came across my status on WhatsApp. I mean, our resident pastor at LFC Obantoko, Pastor Savior Evanga. So, and he was like, I only came across my status one day like this. I posted a baby, and you know, the naming that video of our naming ceremony I posted. And then he was like, ha, mommy wasn't like, I'm sure this girl don't give birth to me. Like, I was literally laughing all through the process of, like, all through that time, it was. Speaking like he was saying it to like, so I was just laughing because it was so funny. He said that mommy said, I beat this girl, and she told me, I beat this girl don't born, she never told us. And I was like, okay, she first said, I beat this girl don't marry, she never told us, she never called us. I was like, no, 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 I can never do that. Like, I swear with the baby. Please don't have the baby. The baby's mine. The baby's actually for my big brother, so the baby's for me also. So then it was not like I trust my daughter. There's no way she will get married and then she will never call us or never inform us. No, we can't get to that point. No, 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 no. So I was like, after me, I'm still a small girl, and you know, jokingly I said it. It wasn't as if I mean it or something like that. I said it joking. I said that statement jokingly. I was just joking. And I was like, if you see the way blast me, if you see the way blast me. So it was like, marriage is not meant like. It's not until when you get to this certain age that's when you're supposed to marry, or you don't determine marriage by your own. By your own plan, according to your own plan. See, I got a lot of messages from him that day, and from since then, my mentality about marriage changed. Sincerely, my mentality about marriage changed. I was like, hey, did I want my own plan? Okay, I'm a final year student for now, and very soon, very, very soon, very, very soon. The experience for me is that very soon I'll get married and stuff like that. I'll continue my education as well. But you know, say that, what if God's in God's plan for my life? Praise only Lord, okay, Jew. But what I like, what if in God's plan for my life it is married? Marriage is the next step. Are you getting me? It was like, what if in God's plan for my life, marriage is the next step? And I was like, eh. He asked me one question and I was so sensitive. The question is so sensitive. I was like, so guys, that day it was actually like I felt like the scale on my eyes, on my spiritual eyes has been removed, has been taken away. Like, it went on and on and on and on and on to continue like It was like a cancel. Like he went on and on to cancel me, and at the end it was glory. It was like the reason why. Yeah, later I sat down and I observed that thing that his statement. He said the reason why some of our sisters they get married late is because. So he said the reason why some of these are spiritual sisters are really like our spiritual sisters, some of the reason, or let me say one of the reason why they get married late. Let's get real here. He said the reason why they get married late is because some of them they feel like it's not yet my time. Are you not getting it? Did you get what I just said? Like they feel like it's not yet my time, like what will me get married now? How old am I? I'm still a small girl, stuff like that. And then they mix religion with relationship. These things, they are two different things entirely. That you are in a relationship does not mean that you should carry your religion. And that's what is wrong with our sisters these days. Sincerely, they feel like this one, this one care. When they look at it, like, this one care. This one does not go to church. This one knows this. See, I'm not saying you should go to a club and go and pick a life partner from that place. No, where you worship or where you serve God, then that place where you serve God, where you worship God, your life partner should be able to come from that place if truly you worship God very well. So the thing is, well, like some of these assistants, they were like, me marry this one, okay, this one that. This one that his service is not even complete. It's this, is that, is not. So they mix everything with over spirituality. I'm not saying you should not be spiritual. Sincerely, when it comes to relationship, you have to be spiritual. But hey, put spirituality apart and then deal with your relationship. Then you now bring spirituality into it. Balance everything. Let everything be balanced. Stop over spiritualizing your what would I even say, your relationship life. No, it's not fair. That's the reason why some of our sisters are having, or our brothers, in quotes, some of our sisters and our brothers are having late marriage because they believe that no, it's not yet time. It's not yet their time. That day was like, and he asked me one personal question, like, did I want my own plan to overrule God's plan? Whose plan should overrule one? Like, whose plan should overrule? Is it God's plan or my own? And I was like, this one is usual. And like, no, it should, God's plan should overrule mine, because what's my own plan? What's my own plan concerning like, what's my own plan to the plan God has for me? You know, it's great, very great, very, very great plan. So since that day I've been like, yes, God, let your will just be done in my life. If you tell me I'll get married this year, I'll just say, let your will. Before I'll just argue with you, I'll be like, sure, wow, okay. Sincerely, that's me. I'll be like, sure, wow, okay, she will go all right, clearly. But now, when you talk to me about marriage and you're like, this year you must get married or stuff like that, I say, God, let your will be done in my life. God, let your will be done in my life. So I don't argue with you again. So if you like, see marriage vision. If it is God's will for my life, it will surely come to pass. If it is not God's will now, like if it is not part of God's plan for me now, then it will not. Like seriously, if I continue on and on and on and on to tell you what he told me that day, you'll be like, wow. I was like, wow. I bless God I went to church that day, because actually what I went for wasn't like, I went to a program. I thought that program is going to hold that day. And see, if I tell you that I just managed myself to go, you believe it? I struggled, like I dragged myself. I dragged myself to church. And I got there, I was just like, I didn't go to any program. Jesus, I got to cry. But eventually, at the end, when I go back to hostel that night, and I was like, I sat down and I meditated on what he told me. I was like, wow, Holy Spirit, thank you. This is the reason why you took me to church. Thank you. Because if it is on the normal service days, daddy will not have time. We will not have time to be canceling you. But because that day was so free, so he asked us to talk to me, and I bless God sincerely. since that day on, my this thing, my perspective about marriage has changed. So please and please, whenever you're in a relationship, I'm not saying you should not go into a relationship, be careful. Sincerely, be careful, be careful, be careful, be careful. Don't, he warned me that day several times, like he warned me like this that day several times. He said, don't ever mix religion with relationship. There are two different things apart. Like, don't, when I'm talking about relationship, I'm not talking about marriage. Don't ever miss, I'm not talking about this phone, cashing phone relationship. So, like, don't ever miss religion. Don't miss it with, you say somebody wants to, like, if this person is not even for you. Me, I'm the type that I, like, how will I even say it? I don't like going out. I just like being on my own. So, if you want to see me, okay, I, sincerely, when was that this story I want to say? Ah, Jesus. But I was to say, okay, there was a time I have somebody that was disturbing me. And I was like, I met this person in school when we resumed. I met this person and I was like, oh God, what is wrong? And I was like, me, I'm not on my own. I don't even have anything like that in my mind. And this person kept on disturbing me, disturbing me, disturbing me. I was like, okay, come to my hostel. Me, I don't go out. That's one thing. If you want to take me out, okay, maybe I will change now. I'll start going out. Maybe I'll change. I'll start going out. But not out. Not that, like going to club. No, 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 no. Don't bring that one. The thing is, I told this person, okay, come today. Fortunately for him, the day he came, I went to church. He didn't meet me. The second day, he was like, hey, he chats me off. He called me. I mean, I was not even in mood to pick his call. I was just looking at that phone like this. Phone was ringing, ringing, ringing. I was just like, "Simba to buy here, you will stop. You cannot come and kill me." So I placed the phone on the floor. I was like, "Okay, later on in the night, he not chat me up. I was not like, oh, sorry, I saw your missed call, but I'm not able to speak, cause sorry." And he was like, he wanted to ask if he would meet me in the hostel. Like, I said, "Okay, come. I'm in the hostel." Did he come? I don't even know whether he came or he didn't come. Okay, he came. So he came. He came or he came. But when he called me, I wasn't with my phone then. I wasn't with my phone, sincerely. I wasn't with my phone. So I never knew somebody was calling. You're coming to come and see a lady at night. What kind of coming is that one? Come in the afternoon when everybody will see you. Although there's nothing he will use me to do. Because you should people will just stand outside the hostel and then we'll talk. That's... see, whenever if I don't have any feelings for you, just forget it. This person I already knew personally in my spirit. I already knew this person is offline. Pew. That's the end. Kilo wa. Then I feel like so when that thing I said, don't mix religion with relationship. Or like Jesus, am I not already going offline? Like, am I not already off? But later I realized that this person knew. Okay, maybe because they called me now, I was unable to pick your call. I called you back, you not pick, you were not there when I called you. Okay, you now call me later and you're not like, okay, I called you this so day. I was like, I wasn't with my phone. And then he was like, okay, can I see you? Oh, I hate people that always tell me, can I see you? I'm not the type you want to see me. You want to see me once and tell me what you want to tell me and get out. Baby, can I see you today? Can I see this one? Why? So, and I was like, this one, your back people always say something that some people want to negotiate. Like, when you don't have anything to do, you're just disturbing yourself. You already know that this person you are disturbing is not meant for you. You just want to try your luck. But for you, you already know within yourself that your luck is not going to work. So, please and please try in as much as possible to, how will I say it? To ensure that you... So try in as much as possible not to mix religion with relationship. You're a lady, you are a guy, you are a man. Please, you're a pastor, you are a... What kind of church? You're a choir, you're a chorister, you are a what? What are they calling them? Usher? Name it, whatever post you feel in your church. Please, please and please, don't try to mix religion with With relationships, some people, they have missed it. Some people, they've missed it because they mixed relationship with religion. Now, Daddy told me that day that the will of God for us is in two form. It's either for you to choose the perfect one or the permissive one. Permissive one. He said the perfect one is the best one for us. Like his perfect one is the best one, like the complete one. There is no any in that one. Like it's complete. But the permissive one is like an alternative. Yes, the permissive one is like an alternative. Like you just want to just go and manage it. Are you getting it? That's the meaning of that alternative. So be careful. Be very, very careful. Be very, very careful. He said once you've missed the perfect will of God for your life, then the next one you should be expecting is alternative, which is the permissive. And permissive can never be like the perfect will. So be a man, you saw a sister, you know that. You prayed to God about you prayed to God about this person, about your marital life, and you know that this person is very close to you, or this person is even, see, there are sometimes one thing I notice as well is that some people in some relationship, the person or their life partner is so close to them, but it takes them all the power, all the energy for them to like propose. That's where the problem is for some brother or some sisters. They've been praying about it, or some sisters they didn't bother to pray about it. They just go into any relationship they like. No, it shouldn't be like that. Please, it shouldn't be like that. Don't endanger your life. Don't endanger your destiny. Don't endanger the will of God for your life. Please and please, please. So don't ever mix religion with relationship. They are two different things entirely. Serve Christ, but while serving Christ, ensure that this one is for people that are not married. This is meant for people that are not married. And if you are married, there are still some ways you can still bring them in. So the thing is, please and please, during the process of you serving God or of you worshipping God, or I would like to say, during the process of you serving God, please ensure that you don't bring religion into relationship. Go to God in prayer. See, those are the things that he told me, and I'm like, somebody's going to be blessed with this video. I didn't have intention of making this religion over relationship video. I never had it, but this is how I told you initially that this is how the Holy Spirit is going to be leading us, and I blessed the Holy Spirit. Now, don't ever mix religion with relationship. Go to God in prayer. If you see somebody, better stop doing fine girl. If you see somebody propose to you today, let me wait. Tell the person to calm down, wait a bit. Then go to God in your prayer, in your closet, like in your secret place. Go to God in prayer. Ask God, God, what are you saying concerning this person? Is this person your will for my life? Are you saying I should say yes to this person? See, there are different ways the Holy Spirit communicates to us. Are you getting it? The way the Holy Spirit communicates to me is far, far different from the way it communicates to you. So ensure that you are sensitive to that Holy Spirit when he's speaking to you, so that you'll be able to follow his instructions. And when you get it, like when you get your answer, you still need to go and meet people. Don't do it on your own alone. Don't make it your own alone. Ask your mommy to pray for you. Ask your daddy. Ask your parents to pray about it as well. Ask your pastors. They are your leaders, so they should be able to help. Ask them to pray about it as well with you. And when you are done with everything, go for counseling. Don't waste your time. Don't waste your time. And I pray that God is going to help each and every one of us. So this is where I'm going to stop this video for today. I hope you enjoy it. Please ensure that you share and give it thumbs up. Let me know your comments. Let me know your view about this video in the comment section. Thank you guys. I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Like, I think I need to post this one differently. This video, Timoshi, I think I need to post it differently. I'm not going to post it with the other one, so I'm going to post it differently, and I'll not start again. Okay, this is how I'm going to do it. Bye. Yeah, go. Let me start my video. with them. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. What's up? What was I about to say?